The Philippines records its fourth highest daily new infections at over 37,000 Monday, bringing the number of active cases to a new record high for the sixth straight day at almost 291,000. 23 additional deaths, as well as nearly 34,000 new recoveries, were also recorded. 12 labs were not able to submit data. Independent research group Okta sees cases in the National Capital Region declining, although slowly.
Bumaba yung daily growth rate to negative 1% from 2%. So ibig sabihin, naging negative na, mukhang pababa na konti. Pero again, hindi pa tayo pwede mag-celebrate. Hihintayin natin siguro within the next few days or the next week. Pag talagang mas mababa na yung bilang ng kaso next week, masasabi natin na talagang bumababa na.
David adds the region's reproduction number is now lower at 2.67 compared to 6.16 just 11 days ago. Despite this, utmost caution should still be maintained as a rise in cases is now being observed in other regions.
All over the country now, we're starting to see an increase in cases. Meron sa Region 2, meron din sa Region 1 sa Pangasinan, tsaka sa La Union, sa Benguet region, sa Bicol region, other parts of Central Luzon ay medyo bumibilis pa lang. Sa Western Visayas, Central Visayas, even sa yung sinabi ko nga kanina, Tacloban.
The Department of Health says of the samples collected and subjected to genome sequencing in the last week of December, 78% were found to have been infected by the Omicron variant. But this number grew to 97% from samples collected and sequenced in the second week of January. The Omicron variant has also been detected in 15 areas in the NCR. But health spokesperson Maria Rosario Vergara clarifies that the non-detection of the variant in two areas may be due to lower sample submission and does not mean that Omicron is not present there. Their findings establish that not only is there community transmission of the Omicron variant in the NCR, but it is now also predominant in the region. Aside from Omicron, the spike in cases was attributed to increased mobility, reduced adherence to protocols, and delays in detection and isolation. For infectious disease specialist Dr. Ronjin Solante, data in the coming days will be crucial in determining the trajectory of cases.
Because if it will still be increasing, then that will be nearing the peak. Most likely, we are already beyond the peak.
And even if a person has already been infected by Omicron, reinfections can still happen, even if the individual is fully vaccinated.
Reinfection is always possible. There's no such thing as lifelong immunity against any infection.
Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.